Hey YouTube, AppleX142 here, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can jailbreak iOS 9.3.5 using the newest Phoenix jailbreak on your 32-bit iPhone, iPod Touch or iPad. And this is a semi-untethered jailbreak, which means you will need to have an application installed on your device in order to re-enable your jailbreak every single time you reboot your device. I'll explain a little bit more about that later in the video. But as I said, this is for 32-bit devices, meaning that it's only going to work with older devices such as the iPhone 4S, 5, 5C, iPad 2, 3 and 4, iPad mini 1st generation and the iPod Touch 5th generation. It's not going to work with newer devices such as the iPhone 5S and above and the newer iPads and iPod Touches as well. So that's something you need to bear in mind. This is only for 32-bit devices, and the most useful device that this is for is actually the iPad 2 and the iPhone 4S, since those are devices that their final firmware version was iOS 9.3.5, and then using this you can also downgrade it to older versions if you really want to, which I'm going to have a guide released soon on how to do that. But as you can see, here's a full list of all the devices that this is compatible with, and there's also a list of ones that it's not compatible with. This link will be in the video description below, which is where you're going to need to go to get all this information here, which you should read before attempting this, as well as your download links and your written guide if you want to follow this that way. But as you can see, if you just go to the website here, you're going to need to download a couple of things. First thing you're going to need to download is the Phoenix IPA file. So this does work through an application, similarly to the Yalu jailbreak or the Pangu ones that we've had in the past. So you just click on this link, and it'll bring you to the Phoenix website, and then basically what you want to do is just click on the red download button down here, and that'll download the latest version of the IPA file. Then, once you've got that downloaded, you're going to also need to download Cydia Impactor if you don't already have it. Download the latest version for your operating system using these links here, and then basically you'll get a zip file, just extract it, and in there you should see the Impactor file, which you can then open and run. And I've already got that installed on my computer, so it's in my start menu here, and I've also got the IPA file that we need right here. As you can see, what I've got here is an iPhone 4S running iOS 9.3.5. This jailbreak does only work with those versions, so if you have a device that's on a lower firmware version, I'll also have a link to my other jailbreak for the 9.1 to 9.3.4 jailbreak in the video description for 32-bit devices if you really want to follow that way. Although, to be fair, if you're on anything above iOS 9.3, I'd probably recommend just going to 9.3.5 and doing it this way rather than using another jailbreak. But as you can see, we've got the device here. It's pretty obvious it's on 9.3.5. And as you can see, what we're going to need to do is just basically install that application onto the device using Cydia Impactor. So if we open up Cydia Impactor on our device, make sure that, or on our computer rather, and make sure our device is plugged into the computer, you should see it's detected here in this drop-down menu. If you have multiple devices plugged in, just make sure you select the one that you want to install the application on in this drop-down menu here. And then basically what you want to do is get the Phoenix IPA file that you have and basically just drag it on top of the Cydia Impactor window. That'll bring up a new prompt saying you can log in with your iTunes iCloud app or ID. So it's basically going to ask you for your Apple ID and passwords. But so don't worry about this. Your password isn't sent to anywhere except for Apple. Although if you really feel a little bit uneasy about this, you can also just create a spare iTunes account and use that if you really want to. But in my case, I'm just going to use one of my own ones. So it's just going to be this email here. And then once you type that in, just click on OK. And then it'll ask you to type in your password. So I'm just going to do that quickly. And then if you press OK, you can see it will start installing the application on our device. So this may take a little while depending on how fast your device is in your computer and your connection to your device, but it should only take a maximum of 30 seconds to a minute. If you do get an error message like this saying you already have an iOS development certificate, what you basically need to do is go to this Xcode tab up here in Cydia Impactor and then click on Revoke Certificates, then just put your Apple ID in again, and then it will basically just revoke the certificates and it should fix the error for when you do it the next time. So I'm just going to do that now. And then after a few seconds, you should get a message saying that however many certificates were revoked. So just give it a few seconds. It says one certificate revoked. Then if we try and do this again, as you can see, it should work this time. That's one of the most common errors you can get when using Cydia Impactor, so that's just one thing you need to bear in mind if you do get that error. But after that, if you do get it, it should be pretty smooth sailing, and then just give it a few seconds and it should install the application on your device, and you should see it appear in the next available slot on your home screen. Now, when you first install this, it's not going to be able to be opened straight away. You're going to need to go into the settings application and basically just trust yourself as a developer or as a installed client, basically, and then it will basically be able to be opened on the device. The other thing you need to note about in doing it this way is that since you don't have a paid Apple developer account, more than likely, if you do have one, that's great, you don't really need to worry about this, but if you don't have a paid Apple developer account, this application is going to stop working after 7 days, at which point you're going to need to reinstall it. And you do need to reinstall it because you need the application on your device in order to be able to re-jailbreak your device after rebooting. So that's just something you really need to bear in mind. But as you can see, we now have this Phoenix application. As you can see, if I try and open it, we're going to get that error message I said about. So you just go over to the settings application, then go to general. This is an iPhone 4S, so it's probably going to be quite slow. But we go down to general, and then if we scroll down to right underneath the VPN, we should see device management or profiles on device management. Tap on your Apple ID, tap on trust, trust again. And then once that's done, if we go back out, we should be able to open up the application and it should work perfectly fine. And then you should see something like this. There's a few different options in here for mixtape player, but basically just completely ignore that. That's just some music that they included in it as a kind of a joke. But basically just tap on the prepare for jailbreak button, tap on accept. You're going to get a little notification here. Just tap on dismiss, then proceed with jailbreak at the bottom, and then begin installation. It's quite a process to do that. But as you can see, it's going to come up with a new message saying use provided offsets. So don't worry about the second option. Just click on the blue one. And then this is the point where it can be a little bit iffy. So you saw the screen sort of dimmed there. That means that the jailbreak actually failed this time around. So it's not 100% going to work all of the time. It is a bit hit and miss, where sometimes it will work and sometimes it doesn't. So it may take a couple of times just to get it to actually work. But basically what you want to aim for is for it to press that button, maybe take about a minute for it to go through the whole process of jailbreaking and installing Cydia, and then it will respring your device. You shouldn't see the Apple logo, but you may, depending on your device or what your situation is. But basically what you want it to do is just go through that and then respring. So if this does happen and it reboots like this is when it shows the Apple logo, that basically just means you need to try it again, go back into the application, do the exact same thing again, and then hope that it works that time. So usually it happens on the second or third time, sometimes the first, but that's just something you really need to bear in mind. But if we go back in here, we just swipe to unlock, and then if we go back into the application and then just do that again, hopefully it will work this time. So we tap on begin installation or begin jailbreak, tap on use provided offsets, and as you can see, the screen didn't actually dim there, but that doesn't mean it's in the clear just yet. So it's going through the whole process of patching things and installing Cydia. Just tap on done if you get that storage almost full error, and then basically I think that has worked. That basically just means that it's going to respring and hopefully Cydia will be on our home screen. Like I said, if you go through this and it doesn't appear on your home screen, just keep trying it and do it again until hopefully it does work. Hopefully it has worked this time, but if not, I'll just do it again and it will work eventually. So that's just something you need to bear in mind. And you may get something similar to this whenever you're re-enabling the jailbreak as well. So hopefully just try not to reboot your device too much. But yeah, just bear with me when I'm going through this. This may not work this specific time, but we'll just keep doing this until it works and then I'll come back when it does. Okay, and as you can see, that actually did work this time. We have Cydia on our home screen. If we tap on it, we should hopefully be able to open it. If not, we basically probably means that the jailbreak needs to be enabled. But as you can see, it did work perfectly fine. The Cydia application is loading. Didn't need to do it more than the two times that time, but your mileage may vary with that. But as you can see, we've got Cydia on our home screen, fully functional. It's doing its whole thing with refreshing the sources. And when it's done that, you're going to need to install a bunch of updates. But yeah, that is pretty much it. Basically, now what you want to do is if you ever reboot your device, you're going to want to go back into the Phoenix application. You won't be able to open up any of your jailbreak applications and your tweaks won't be enabled if you do reboot your device. And basically, you just want to go back into this application. There should be a button here that says Kickstart Jailbreak. Then just go through the exact same process as we did to actually do the jailbreak. And it should re-enable the jailbreak. And you'll know that because Cydia will start working again. But that is pretty much it. Like I said, all the links you need for this will be in the video description. I'll also have a link to some previous jailbreaks down there as well. I'll probably just put the playlist guide down there if you want to see previous jailbreaks there. And I'll also have a link to how to actually downgrade this version to older iOS versions on the iPhone 4S when I've actually got that up, which will hopefully be going up today or tomorrow. So just stay tuned for that. Make sure to subscribe to the channel to be updated with more cool guides like this. And so yeah, that's pretty much it. Like the video if you liked it, leave a comment if you have any questions, and as always, don't forget to subscribe.